Okay, so now we are going to discuss the next numerical. A river 800 meters wide flows at the rate of 6 kilometers per hour. There is a swimmer who can swim 10 kilometers per hour in still water, and he wishes to cross the river straight. Tell us along which direction he must strike and what should be his resultant velocity. At last, how much time he would take. So basically, we need to answer three things over here. Along what direction he must strike, what should be his resultant velocity, and how much time he would take to do that. So let us try to understand the problem in hand. So there's a river which is flowing at the rate of 6 kilometers per hour. At the rate of 6 kilometers per hour. Let us take it V2. You have already discussed with me the boat and river problems. So it resembles, it's a swimmer and a river problem. So largely resembles. Here's the swimmer, right? Now he wishes to cross this river straight. But we know that the river flow will not let him do that. Even if he will try to cross this river straight, the river flow will divert him from his original path, and eventually he will not be able to cross this river straight. So he has to be tricky enough over here. He has to move intentionally in this direction. Okay, so he would have to move in this direction, because when he would move in this direction, the river flow would eventually divert him and he will be moving along this path then. Okay, so now it is told that in still water he can move with a speed of, with a velocity of 10 kilometers per hour, which is the man's velocity V1. So now let us complete this parallelogram. Okay, now I've completed this parallelogram. The width of the river, that means this much, that is given to be 800 meters. Remember that. So now this is the resultant velocity V. Okay, so if a swimmer is intentionally moving along this path and the river flow is diverting him, so the resultant velocity will be V, and we need to find out that. So this is V1, this is V2 vector. So if this is V2, this will also be V2. If this is V1, this will also be V1. Reason being, opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, so what are we going to do next over here? We need to see this triangle, which is including our resultant. Okay, and we can see that these two triangles, this triangle has our resultant V, which is the base of this triangle. See, this is a right angle triangle. This is the hypotenuse, this is the perpendicular, this is the base. So if you want to find out V, you need to find out base. So Pythagoras theorem, perpendicular square plus base square equals to hypotenuse square. So V2 square plus V square equals to V1 square. So this goes as V square equals to V1 square minus V2 square. V equals to under the root V1 square minus V2 square. Now you can solve it and get your answer. We know that V1 is the velocity of the swimmer, which is 10 kilometers per hour. And V2 is the velocity of the river flow, which is 6 kilometers per hour. So this goes as 100 minus 36, 64, 8 kilometers per hour. Now what about, see, I have answered one of the questions. I have answered this. Now I need to find out theta, along what direction the swimmer must go so that the river flow eventually turns him straight. So I need to find out this theta, right? So how to find it? We know that sine theta equals to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, V2 upon V1. So V2 is given to be here, V2 is given to be 6, V1 is given to be 10. So this goes as 2, 3 is a 6, 2, 5 is a 10. So sine theta equals to 3 upon 5, theta equals to sine inverse 3 upon 5, right? So after that, what you need to do, I have found theta also. We need to find out now time taken to cross the river. Time will be the distance actually traveled divided by the velocity. Time is equals to distance upon velocity. Distance is nothing but 800 meters which eventually you traveled. After that, velocity is 8 kilometers per hour. Okay, so this goes as 800 meters is the distance, but the speed is in 8 kilometers per hour. Okay, so let us convert it into meters per second. So 800 meters is the distance. Time equals to distance 800 meters divided by velocity, which is 8 kilometers per hour. Let us do it 1000 into 3600. So this goes as, these are cancelled, 800 divided by 80 into 36. So this is 360 seconds. 360 seconds is the time taken to cross the river. 360 seconds means 6 minutes, I think. So overall the swimmer will need 6 minutes to cross the river. Okay. And now, based upon this, I am giving you a question to solve, which you will be solving and answering me. Okay, so the question is, a river is flowing with the speed of 5 kilometers per hour. A river is flowing with the speed of 5 kilometers per hour. A boatman can row with a speed of 10 kilometers per hour in still water. Okay. So after that, he rows his boat in river at right angles to the bank of the river. If width of the river is 800 meters, okay, listen to me. He rows his boat in the river at right angles to the bank of the river. Now, if the width of the river is 800 meters, can you tell us how much time the boat man will take to cross the river? How far away from a point just opposite to the bank of the river he will be reaching there? What will be his effective speed, overall speed? You know that this case resembles to the case when I told you that when the river flow is actually like this and you are trying to row the boat in this direction, and then the river flow will take you in this direction, isn't it? So this will be your resultant velocity. Now you have to find out the magnitude of this resultant velocity. You have to find out this distance that at the point where you were supposed to go, how far from that point you have reached. So you need to find out this. You need to find out the resultant velocity. And you will be finding out the overall time that was taken by the boatman. So do it and answer it. Okay?